Greetings, everyone. I am Favian with CrystalsAvatar.com. And today, just as this title of the video mentions, we will be talking about the forbidden knowledge about Egyptian and Atlantean ascension, the truth about building the pyramids, the Sphinx, the secrets to the Egyptian Ankhs, and also the truth about what it really is, the Ark of the Covenant. This will be a mini-series called Ascension Atlantis Egypt Mystery Series. And so, you know, instead of making one big long video, like my previous one, for example, was 3 hours, 15 minutes. And this one's about the same, even a little bit more. So this time, I'm sorry, I don't want to torture you so much. So we're going to make it a long, you know, I mean, several pieces of the long video. So, but it will be in a succession and as a playlist like this, like you're watching now. And this is the first video, so that's why we have to say it for the first time. And we'll be breaking it down into, like, you know, several videos. And actually, you know, this is actually part two of my previous video called Turanisium, Angelic Human Race. That was a really jam-packed, like, three-hour video documentary, basically breaking down our race genetic hybridization experiment. You know, explaining, like, about how the 12 tribes of star seeds and the earth seeds, holy ones, Machiwa, that some of you are connected to, and you yourself were seated on earth in three separate seedings in order to develop your DNA that we talk about here on this channel, Crystal's Avatar. Now, you know, we want to get it back, because right now we're at this low, you know, 3D level of our awareness, consciousness. We want to get back our 12-strand DNA, you know, potential, so, you know, that we can ascend back to the original, you know, homeworld of ours, you know, Planetara. And if you haven't watched the part one video, please do so, you guys, seriously, because otherwise you may be a little bit lost, because we talk a lot about a Templar comp, you know, topics in dimensions, densities, the time matrix, time continuums, you know. And, you know, so this is going to be a continuation of where we left off in the other video, and which will be this series now. I'm calling it a series, you know, like detailed about our current, you know, third seeding, because we've been in three, but this is about the third one of the angelic human race, the Turanisiums. They're called Turanisiums. We're from Tara. We're density two. This is what this is all about. Going back to Tara, because we're at this lower level Earth. But it's part of who we are, but we need to get back to Tara. And I talk about how in the first seeding and the second seeding were destroyed. Well, the thousand years war between the Elohim and the negative Anunnaki, okay, because there is positive ones, but the negative ones, and it was an end to the second seeding of the, you know, the human lineage on Earth that you were part of course. And so throughout this playlist video series, we will be going over, like, the events of the, you know, the current third seeding, you know, like there's different types of levels of Lemurian, no, not levels, but types of Lemurians and types of Atlanteans, because there's been three different seedings. But this is still happening now. Right now, this is the third seeding. And so this is why this is more modern, more relative, because we're talking about the Egyptians, the Hebrews, and such. So now, you know, well, about the advanced genetics of the Egyptian and Hebrews and their extraterrestrial origins. You know, there is earth seeds, star seeds. So some are from terrestrial, some are extraterrestrial. So, and, you know, we also talk about the Egyptian gods, Isis, Osiris, Horus, Hathor, and Anubis. Also about the emerald, what's called the emerald, it's called, well, there's levels of DNA, and we're talking about the emerald sun DNA. So these are emerald sun Orophim angels, and also we'll be talking about Azrael dark angels, gargoyles, and the creation of the Ark of the Covenant, about the rod and the staff. And realize these aren't from Christian perspectives or religious perspectives, it's from the Long One. We're talking about also the blue flame, Earth's, some of you have heard of frequency fence, what's that all about? And also about, you know, that created a galactic quarantine. And stargates, don't forget about the pyramid ascension chambers, rainbow round tables, Arthur, King Arthur, the destruction of Atlantis, also the removal, again, of the sphere of Amenti, which I talked about in a previous video, and also the Great Flood, which is actual several floods combined into one story, but it's actual several floods. And we're also going to be talking about the Andromeda Galaxy. And information about the organization, well, there's different, you know, it's, we're looking at our planet level, well, there's galactic level, okay, and, you know, metagalactic level, so, and there's an organization called the Syrian-Arcturian Coalition for Interplanetary Defense, for example, and also the Interdimensional Association of Free Worlds, which is a, we'll talk about that, much greater, you know, it's like a legion of archangels, the greatest, I mean, of angels, of, you know, of part of this Christos. And so there was a lot, there's a lot to talk about. And remember when we last left off in like the previous video, we were at the end of the second seeding, and it was after like a time period of like positive development, actually, for a little while anyways, right? And the human evolutionary DNA imprint, you know, it began to prosper. And if you haven't seen the other video, there's going to be years like this. It was about 900,000 years ago that are going to freak you out. What? 900,000 years ago? Yes, holy ones. We are ancient. We are ancient from, you know, 900,000 years ago. You know, there was the Elohim and the Syrian Council. Well, they're from other planets. And the Ceres Egyptians. Oh, Ceres Egyptians. And the Palladorians of Density Universe 2. And they re-entered the sphere of Amenti, well, back into the Earth, you know, planetary core in D2, that's dimension 2. And remember, the sphere of Amenti is part of our ascension process. And so, you know, anyone else there who's teaching ascension, how are you not talking about the sphere of Amenti? You should be talking about the sphere of Amenti. It is part of our ascension process. We need it here, actually, in density 1 on Earth to ascend. Okay, so, you know, our soul matrix is from density 2 of Tara. This is what I teach and talk about and remind you. You know this knowledge, holy ones. You know, so, you know, the sphere of Amenti is like our surrogate race, you know, morphogenetic field, while we evolve down here. Because we are evolving to the future angelic human race. Our race is part of a greater race, understand. It represents the gestalt energy field of our Turanesium race consciousness with that 12-strand DNA template, okay? You know, most spiritual systems that talk about ascension don't even mention the sphere of Amenti because they have no knowledge of it, no awareness of it, no connection. They don't have the connection, understand. That's because it has been forbidden knowledge. But this knowledge is always brought back to Earth during ascension periods, okay? And which is what our race, our human race, is going through right now. And I talked about this ascension process. Basically, Christos Avatar is about ascension mechanics. We're laying down the framework. You're getting the real history of our human race and also these techniques and knowledge and that will empower you instead of disempower. You know, but it's always brought back during ascension periods. And so the whole Amenti rescue mission, well, that got seated down here in the first place was, you know, the creation of a new set of stargates, you know, like the name of this video. We're going to be talking about stargates and understand when you're talking about the science of stargates, you're talking about the science of ascension. So remember, they're called the Halls of Amenti. And that would, you know, allow this planet to evolve back to its original, you know, Taran pattern. And that would allow us to evolve our DNA back to Tara. You know, when you ascend, it's like traveling through time because you're going to a future period of time of this, of yourself, your own biology, consciousness, and also the planet. So we've been sitting on a treasure, you guys, ever since we've been here. And this is one of the, yes, the big things that the dark interstellar races that try to control here do not want us to know. Okay, many people have different names or ideas about these overlords, these fallen angelics. And, you know, there are several Stargates in Amenti, not just the important ascension portals. And Stargates, well, they're very important to these negative ET races because Stargates have this vertical axis, okay, upwards, downwards. You can get into another density, you know, universe, like, very quickly, easily. If you're on the negative side, right, are you on the negative side, Holy Ones? And if your idea is to create dominion in as many systems as you can, well, the Stargates are, well, very special for that. Because with those babies, you don't have to go the long way through a system. It's like, there's a difference, actually, between Stargates and portals. Because a portal could be horizontal in the time cycles, time continuums, or it could be vertical, and you want to go vertical to be changing in different levels of density and matter. You don't have to go the long way through a system. You can zap right in, you know, and just infiltrate very quickly. That's what some of these beings have done. Whole systems have been lost. And we currently exist in, well, this low density level one on Earth. But the sphere of Amenti Stargates are very special because they can connect you right through to Density Universe 2 Tara, and also Density Universe 3 Gaia, and even all the way up, you know, to Density 5. But Density 3 and Gaia, in the center of the planet called Gaia, there is like this... I talked about them in my other video. It's a connection through the Stargates, or, you know, and to this one connects to a planet called Mintaka in the Ryan star system. Some of you have heard of the system, you know what kind of races also come out of the system. So, but the Amenti Stargates, well, they connect to those Mintaka Stargates. All right. So what's connected to what's called the Metagalactic Core. Or you would just say the center point of, you know, it's like of dimension, well, between 1 and 15, that's the center point, and that's dimension 8, D8, and that's where consciousness enters and leaves out of the time matrix, which I talk about in detail in my other videos, so check them out. And out of the entire system, this is one of the ways to get out of the hologram of matter, to leave this and go into other systems, okay? It's also a gateway to the energy matrix of non-dimensionalization. We're in the dimensionalized system called a time matrix. The beings that exist in the energy matrix are outside of this hologram, illusion, Maya, because, and they're in the, you know, this is where the Ascended Masters exist. And it's all in the, gateway to other holograms, other time matrix systems, you know, that's what you officially call them. We talk, you say there's no time, New Agers will say, there's no time. You're in a time matrix that has planetary time cycles, you have time continuums, you have time vectors, there's some relation of time. And so when it comes to, you know, you're going to want those babies because they are the Stargates that are going to, well, get you out of your own little neighborhood and into those dimensions that exist beyond. Okay, so that sounds like a threat to these negative arc, you would say, anti-life, anti-Christos beings are trying to control this system. And the D8 Mintaka Stargates, they've been under high security since the beginning of life forms in this time matrix because of that threat factor. Okay? So you hear about all these wars and you think the war's about this. Sometimes the war is about a Stargate, understand. This is something that's very, what you call, people are underestimating this in the spiritual communities. It's a big part of this whole process. And it's so also, you know, people and beings in this time matrix don't get a chance to mess with the evolution and free will of beings in other time matrices. And outsiders don't get, you know, to mess with us. So as far as top line security, Mintaka is it. And well, there's been many actual, you know, like you see in Star Wars, you know, many planetary systems lost, you know. So just the defense, you know, making sure that the Mintaka portals stay under Guardian, you know, control. Because if they're not, it has horrible consequences, you know. Not necessarily for, you know, this time matrix, but for those other ones out there, those innocent or unrelated ones out there. They don't need our phantoms to go attack their, free will. So, anyways, these halls of Amenti, they were created to allow our race and this planet to re-evolve. But they also created this, you know, security risk because they connected to the Mintaka portals. So, you know, because of that, there were energy seals put on these portals, you know, blockages. And only under, like, well, certain conditions, you know, could these babies open. This is Stargate mechanics, you know, scalar mechanics. Learning about the energy universe, the particle universe, but there's an anti-particle universe, all of this Templar mechanics, universal galactic understand. So those artificial seals were put on them, you know, and that was before, you know, we're starting. Some of the beings, like I mentioned, are releasing those seals. And the only ones that can release the Stargate security seals are those Emerald Sun Orifim races, or actually Indigos and Starseeds from Inner Earth, because they are the ones that have, well, how can I say this? The keys in their body, and literally, like, the electrotonal patterns of their DNA, encryption key codes. They're also called, like, DNA fire letters. And I'm going to be making a video just about those. So, but, you know, these DNA codes are what enable the races to release the Stargate seals. You know, that's why such races are the guardians of our planetary Stargates. And, you know, this is a spiritual war, energy war, consciousness war, a polarity, understand? That's how this simulation works. That's the way it was designed by the original creators. And we are the guardians on the Earth level, Tara level, Gaia level, and, excuse me, all the way up to the Armitana level. And some of you are Orifim or Indigo. And, well, the first level of the human pattern started in Density 2 Tara. That's what I've been talking about in these series of videos. You know, it started with the Emerald Sun Orifim, the high-level being. Remember, we come up here and go downwards, so we're part of what was up here, we are up here. And so, you know, an aura from Orifim refers to light. These are good guys. They had 30 to 48 strand capacity, which is, you know, the Emerald Sun DNA matrix. And the highest level, the highest, you know, 48 would be the highest. Then they created, well, they downgraded to, like, smaller versions of themselves, less consciousness, less energy in the lower levels, you know. And also, they're also, these lower ones are also in Density 2, but they are Orifim, regular Orifim, not the Emerald Sun Orifim. And the Orifim had 24 to 30 strands, still a masterful being, you know, but that was their capacity, which is, this DNA level is called the double diamond sun DNA matrix, you know, because there's a double diamond, and this one's the double diamond, because it has 24. So, now, it reduced it a little bit, you know, this Orifim and this Orifim, it reduced it, and into these Orifim, the regular ones, were seated the original Ternesium angelic human race. This is why we're connected to the angels, to being an angel, which are us, the 12 strands, the diamond sun 12 strand DNA imprints, you know, from the stellar races. And that's our heritage. And it created the full strand Ternesium race. That's where it became Ternesium. Orifim angels became the original Ternesium angelic humans by adding, you know, to their patterns of the 12 tribe races. And I even list them on my website. Check it out. The 12 tribes that needed to help. And, you know, it's also in the other Ternesium video, the first one. And they just needed to help in their, you know, their evolution. So we have the Ternesiums created now in Tara, the Tara level. And out of those came, like, well, two primary divisions, because we always have division and polarity. Did you not notice? you know, you can't ignore one side. You can't not acknowledge one side. So, anyways, you know, it's where, again, the Anunnaki, the negative Anunnaki, interbred with some of the Ternesium. So you get two races interbreeding, that's a hybrid, you know, and they bred with some of the Orpheum, that's another hybrid. So you can create, they're creating, they're creators of the genetics, you know, hybridizing, and they can create some really high-coded nasty beings. Okay, there was a lot of, well, heavy artillery, you know, created in the negative side by combining some of these, you know, very high-coded positive races with distorted races, you know, somewhere you meet somewhere in the middle with those genetics, and like the Azrael race. Some of you have heard of this Azrael. They are actually what you would say avian hominids, bird, you know, genetics, and getting the wing things from the seraphim lines. They were blue. And they became the dark angels in our history. Dark angelic forces, you know, you don't experience or notice or connect to or perceive these realms. So they were the real negative dark angels that have messed with us for a very long time. The fallen angelic race line from the Orion system, and that became known as the Azraelites or the Azrael. But, you know, it sounds a lot like that other race. It's the Azraelites. They were created by the, Omicron, Draconian, Seraphim, Fallen Angelic Legions of Density 4. Well, I can tell you specifically, you know, to mention Tan Orion, and, well, sometimes they steal DNA, you know? It's like they created this through harvesting of genetic material from the race called the Azurites, you know, from Sirius A. That's their planet. That's where all those beings are coming from, you know. And the Azurites, well, they're a super race, which actually blue angels, the highest level of angels, you know, out of all the ones that you know of. So they had murdered these beings, you know. It was like during the Density 2 Syrian Wars, 550 million years ago, to harvest their DNA to create the Azraelites. Nice beings, huh? So, it's like part of our heritage. You're remembering our origins, okay? The beginnings, the fallen angelic Azraelites, not, you know, race, has been involved with, actually, in our earthly affairs as recently as 1930s, so, and also, who else was in the 1930s there, in which they assisted reptilian, well, they're, you would say, actually, that's, you would call them insectoids, Zeta Greys, right, and they're the fallen angelic races, you know, the, it's like when they were negotiating treaties with, like, our human Illuminati, you know, factions, excuse me. So, you know, anyways, again, the only ones that can release those Stargates, you know, security seals, are the Emerald Order Orpheum races. Are you Orpheum, Holy One? Are you Indigo, Starseed, you know? And also the Guardians, so the Guardian Alliance, which also includes, like I said, the Indigo Children and the Starseeds. So, and all those beings are from Inner Earth. And where do you think a lot of those came from? Refugees from all these wars from the seedings. The first one, second one, third one. So, you know, because we were contracted our races, the guardian-like races long ago when the Sphere of Amenti was created. We're responsible if it goes bad. And the last time, you know, these Stargates opened, it went horrible. A lot of us, you know, that are coming in as Emerald Order Orphine, you know, it's like, I don't want to say, like, regrets, but it's like, if only we did this, you know, or if only we had gotten there a little faster, less of us would have been destroyed. So, but ascension periods are a cycle that happens, you know. I show you in my ascension cycle diagram, check it out on my website, and also on the videos that talk about, well, even in the previous video, Turnisian video, you know, and time cycles, period of every 26,556 years. And the last time cycle, you know, or the last time the Stargates opened was several time cycles ago, you know, 210,216 years ago. So that's, what, 10 time cycles? So, yeah, I'm just calculating. We got invaded by a race called the Nephidim, which are Omicron Draconian reptilians. That's where they come out of. And that, you know, we'll talk about more about when we get to into the races. And because there's a lot of information, there's over 99 plus races, right? So they invaded our temples, you know, the temples that were like in use to do our energy mechanics, you know, and also allowed the Stargates, you know, security seals to release and such. That was our responsibility. And the final Stargate seals, it's like we're priests, we're part of the priestcraft. So. So we're helping the humans with their ascension process. Okay, we're babysitters, we're teachers, healers, what you would call inspiration. Okay, so the final Stargate seals were not permitted, you know, to release. It would have allowed them, you know, they had begun to invade the halls of Amenti, and we were not permitted to release the final Stargate seal, you know. If you do not release the Stargate, well, security seals on the Minty Hall Stargates, you know, when they go into an opening cycle, Stargate Activation Cycle, or also called a Transmutative Cycle, but for the planet, you know, it will put the planet into pole reversal, okay? That's what they're designed to do. It's not a joke. It's very fast. It's very final. Okay? Okay? I'm not here to, like, preach doom and gloom and, well, pole reversal. We're here, the Guardian Alliance, the Emerald Order, to stop it from happening. Okay? Because if we don't, the other negative ET groups involved on this planet would, dearly love to see it happen. Oh, pole reversal? Yeah, that's in their idea. A good thing, understand? There is some, I would say, anti-human sentiment going on in those higher densities. So, you know, it's like, it would, like, seriously, it's not a joke. Pole tilt would release, like, a lot of real estate, you know, the planet, for their control. So a pole tilt will kill us. Get rid of us, and then they would take over the planet. And like the few, like, remaining, whoever's unlucky enough to be one of the remaining, you know, few humans that survived, well, they could be the saviors for, and they could put themselves up as little demigods, you know, again, and they could raise you the way they want to. Sound familiar? So, now, when I say Elohai family, remember, it's the blue flame, the Emerald Order. Emerald Order, that indicates blue-green flame. So, the Elohai family that I represent is very, very disgusted at this point. You can sometimes see it in some of that other information because of all of the other, you know, negative family members. We're not... You know, we're not on the dark side. We really care about them, the humans and their, well, evolution. We just want them to go a little slower. Maybe hybridize them with the Anunnaki a little bit more, you know, to make sure they don't have the 12-strand potential. You guys understand, we have 12 strands potential. That means you can have your 12 strands regenerated in your junk DNA, they call it. But, you know, these guys are terrified of you getting your 12 strands of DNA back because you would be equal to them. And then you're going to realize what was done to you, and you're not going to be happy with them. And you understand they know this. They know your potential. So they're afraid. These high-level beings don't want you to have your 12 strand. And, you know, think about it. If they were trying to help, they would try, you know, or be trying to help stop the pending pole reversal here, rather than some of them are teaching how to deal with it after the fact. You hear me? You know? Or they are just, you know, simply trying to teach you, like this New Age message, which is not good or legitimate or love or light. You know, planet Earth is going to turn into a star and raise into the fourth dimension, and poof, we all go into light. Yeah, poof. I mean, yes, the planet will evolve into the fourth dimension, okay, their frequencies and then higher. But it's not supposed to be done by a poof, because if that poof happens, it's not what is being presented. And the Galactic Federation, by the way, is the one telling us that this is going to happen. Understand? The Galactic Federation, I'm asking you if you understand. Because they used to be part of our group, okay? Yeah, they used to be part of the High Council of Eloi. Part of the Law of One. Part of the light, part of the love. They used to, I said. And they decided that, we got sick of the mess of human evolution here. We'll help certain strains, you know, but we think they will be better off, like, being hybridized with the Anunnaki strains. They keep pushing us on the Anunnaki. And we are talking about the negative Anunnaki. We always got to realize, because there's part of this Syrian Council or an Anunnaki, those are good Anunnaki, but when we're talking about this mess, these distortions, obviously, you know, what side. And the Anu race, in particular, will help them develop 11 strands, not 12. And, of course, at the same time, by hybridizing those two groups, it will give the Anunnaki the 12-strand potential, while it dilutes it in us. Okay, not exactly fair. So they were kicked out of the Emerald Order councils because of that. So, this is a spiritual war. This is a drama. This is a memory. This is a, you feel. Or don't. Now, the halls of Amenti Stargates have this built-in security system. It was, you know, built to make sure that if any of them tried to infiltrate these Stargates, and if it was under, like, this guardian control forces that were not meant to be in control of this planet, well, it was, you know. I mean, we get these, they're claiming that they have, they're part of the planet before us, and it's their planet. You know, this was supposed to be the humans' planet. We were appointed as guardians of the whole thing. The Anahazi, the Orophim, going into the Turanisium, going into the human. You know, we were created to be guardians of this particular planetary body. All the way up. And when you understand this world as being a hologram and being made in dimensions, and when I say this, all the way up, we have this level of Earth, we have higher levels of Earth, you have this level of yourself, you have higher levels of yourself. But, you know, so when I say all the way up, up through Earth, up through Tara, up through Gaia, and Armentena. Earth ascends to Tara, Tara ascends to Gaia, and Gaia ascends to Armentena. So, if something else was in, like, possession of this planet, you know, some invaders, some conquerors, some uninvited guests, you know, if something else was in possession, okay, it acts like a recycling cycle. If the period time, this ascension, this alignment came and these gates were due to open, the natural process, right, and those seals weren't lifted because by the Orpheum Indigo Starseeds, if it wasn't opened by one of us and from our DNA and those seals weren't, you know, lifted, there was no beings like that on the planet, you know, no DNA coding to them. It would naturally go into this pole reversal, you know, kind of like a dog shaking off the fleas off his back, you know. So if there's something on the planet that didn't belong in control of this planet, well, the pole reversal would literally clear it. So clear, wipe clean your hard drives, redo your, you know, Windows, whatever. So this is a big deal. This is not good for the life that's on the planet. So I hope to make, you know, be able to get across to you the sincerity of what we're talking about here. It's not a little business that we're dealing with anymore. It's not, you know, these new age groups or even, you know, one of the Christian groups that are, oh, doom is coming over, Armageddon is happening, you know, nice programming. You have to call Jehovah to be saved. We're not one of those groups. You don't have to believe any darn thing I say, right? It doesn't really matter to me. I'm not, you know, it's like, try to imagine living a life without judgment. Can you imagine? You know, can you see? Understand? You know, I'm not going to tell you if you don't believe my way, you're damned. You know, we're your salvation. No. Holy One, brothers and sisters, I'm not your salvation. You are your salvation. But look at this attitude. Look at this ideal. You know, what you find ideal or what you express. What are you thinking about? You are your own salvation. Huh, but I think with that attitude, with that knowledge, you're not going to get very far. So we're bringing in the knowledge if you want to help. And when you help, service to others versus service to self, when you help, the energy work, you know, that is being done here, it will have its rewards for you. There's an incentive. Understand? I'm telling you from experience, Holy Ones, what I've witnessed and I've gone through myself, you don't go through... You don't have a belief. You have a knowing. You experience, and you know it become like a. It will activate the same things in you that you're doing, the healing. You will heal. So we will activate your Kundalini spirals progressively, not at all at once. You would blow up. Understand? High level comes down to this low level of that there's a surge, something like this. It's all about energy. Okay? But you know, you'll be doing a service for this race. Service to others, hello. Service to the human race. And there's people among us. Not everyone, everyone says everyone's the same. Not everyone is the same. What have you done with your spiritual journey and DNA? You know, what that it's this category that fits into the indigo children or the Orpheum category. Obviously, not everyone has a DNA of an indigo, right? So we're not here to ascend ourselves. Hello, indigo. Are you indigo? But we're here to help others ascend. And also the planet. Understand? You know, you guys, you indigo children or Orpheum, you're attracted to this information. This is about your DNA. You know, your body is key to the grid. Our group are you know, to the Earth's grid. It's key to the Taran grid, the Gaian grid, you know, and it's key to the Armentana grid. the highest version, ascended version of the planet. So by running frequency, you know, through your biofields, you can say biofields, energetic, bioenergetic system, you can say chakras. You know, it's called dropping codes, dropping energy codes, information, consciousness. It is ascension mechanics. The process that we call rainbow round tables. You'll be able to take a little piece of coding of this higher Armentana pattern, you know, energy version of our planet, take that. And then you have, you know, in your body, in your DNA, and you put it back in the Earth version of the planet progressively. That's what I'm doing. That's what you're doing. We're learning how to bring this 12th dimensional energy to this level of energy. Peace, my peace, your peace, their peace, their peace. Okay? This level, well, it's a high level Armentana pattern. It was preserved by a group of Orphine. I say preserved. We held it. We're representing this energy under the direction of the Emerald Order, you know, Emerald Sun Orphine, and who agreed to carry that. Agreed. That's a key word. It's part of your covenant. It's part of your purpose here to carry that D12 Armentana imprint. It's a sacred task, holy ones. That electromagnetic imprint, you know, in little tiny pieces as a soul group. And when the time came, it's coming, you know, don't have a perverted mind. The time came just to reset that pattern. They're each putting in their little tiny, you know, piece. And reassemble the pattern of the whole, dropping codes. This is what we're doing in our planetary grid work, holy ones, called, again, rainbow round tables, dropping codes. Each of you have something special within your dormant DNA. We are sacred beings. We're part of this, understand. Something special within your dormant DNA, you know, it will begin to activate the 12th dimensional coding, high-level coding and consciousness within you, okay? But it will also, hey, bring back a piece of the 12th dimensional field of the Armentana level of our planet on Earth. We're bringing that to the Earth. We're healing the races, and we're healing the planet, which is a cohesive unit, by the way. So it will begin to, we're trying to reset that pattern, and it's a density 4 scalar grid of the planet. That's what it is. So, but we're going to continue on to the next part of this video, and I'm so grateful for you guys for watching this series and having this patience, and maybe since it's going to be in pieces, in, you know, a few parts, now you can watch it at a better pace and you won't give up on a big, long, long, long video. So thank you. Please like this video. Please like these videos, you guys. It's important for my channel, and it's also a blessing. It's also bringing our energies together. This is what we want on this earth, and we want this knowledge. We want this light. We want this love. We want this codes. This teaching, remember, we're dropping codes. I love you. This is a tremendous series. It is extraordinary. It is an honor to be part of this, and some of you are part of this. Please like my video. Please subscribe to this channel. You guys, please help sponsor this channel because it's just me. I could really use some help, you guys. And I'm truly grateful for any blessing and any kind thoughts and words, and some of you are part of the same soul family. I love you. I love you all. Love yourself and love others. Peace. Please continue watching the next part. I love you. Thank you. See you.